So I didn't dig toe. All of you should have one of these Chinese finger puzzles. Is anybody who does not? Okay. Here you go, my boss. Okay. I want you to stick your fingers in the Chinese finger puzzle, everybody. Stick them in. And then I want you to pull to get them in. What happens? What happens? They won't come out, right?
You have to do your thumbs.
What's happening?
Thumbs. Well, even small,
I have small fingers, but they won't come out. Now, this is a metaphor for stress. If you fight against it and you struggle with it, you get in there deeper. Right? It isn't by being that you're going to handle stress. It's by being relaxing, pushing both sides in, and then you can get in the other side. So I give you this and the eraser and the ball so you'll remember what we talked about today. So it isn't struggling. It isn't being angry. It's relaxing and interrupting. Okay, so I'm going to tell you, I have two dogs. This is Billie Jean.
Oh, my baby.
Now, Billie Jean is a schnauzer. Schnauzer bark. Anybody have a schnauzer? Schnauzer bark. You have a Pomeranian. All right, so our neighbors were complaining. And I thought, oh my gosh, they're going to report an animal control. So I called Barkbusters. And Barkbusters came out to work with Billie Jean. Are you stuck forever in your
cages? Stuck forever?
Oh, no. Gee, I've never lost anybody's cages.
Who's going to have to do surgery?
Anyway, so Billie Jean, they told me she would start barking. She would get out on the porch. And before she even got to the neighbor side of the yard, she'd be ready. I'm going to bark. And I'm going to bark and bark and bark and bark and bark. The Barkbuster lady said we had to interrupt the barking before she even started barking. Once she got in that posture, like, I'm about to bark, we needed to either take her leash and pull her back in the house or tell her no or whatever it was. If we allowed her to bark and bark and bark, it was like she was on a drunk binge of barking. And it would build and build and build and build, and we could not get her to calm down. It's the same thing with stress. The earlier you interrupt it, the better. It's our perception of things. Like when I talked about speaking and you said some of you liked it, some of you didn't like it. Okay, what's the difference? That's way up at the top. The stressor is speaking. Some of you perceived it as stressful. That got you to hyperventilate, to sweat, maybe to breathe shallowly. And some of you, it wasn't such a big deal. Stress, you are going to do something that ruins your life either physically or mentally. You've got to interrupt it, just like when we did with Billie Jean. I want you to get in touch with your body when it starts to build. And take five. Press your big toe. Use some of the techniques that are in there. Either interrupt it there, or there, or there, or there. Often I'm called into a company because it's a very stressful atmosphere and somebody 40 just died of a heart attack. But there's a dad. And we don't want that to happen to you. We want you to interrupt way before it gets there. These are some of the signs of stress. Okay? Because it may be something mental. Oh gosh, I don't want to face that This is not, I'm really having a tough time in this relationship. It affects your body. These are some of the signs. Some people will drink more, smoke drugs, some get into accidents. You can't find your keys. What did I do with my homework? I can't find it. Can't find a pen that works. Simple things like that. You get colds a lot. It may be because you're under a lot of stress and you need to back off. So what do you do? Well, this is the stress response. Right now, we're sort of all at neutral. And let's say that a swarm of bees came in here. What would you all do?
Scream.
Run, scream. Hide under the chairs. All right. So you would go from being at number one, very calm, right away to number two. Now, this is a good thing. It's good to have that stress response. You don't want to just sit there and say, nice things. I'm just going to think mellow thoughts. No, that's when it's great that you've got a stress response and you're going to run out the door. Well, I'm very handy with these. And so I get them all into a jar, and I say, all right, come in. It's all safe now. So you come back in, these are gone, and that's number three. You go, oh, God, that was close. I'm really relaxed now. And then you go into four, which is really nice, even state that we started out with. Until you have the next stressor. The problem we have in our lives today is we have very little number four. Right? Because there's always something else happening. Then my friend calls me and he's got a problem. Wants me to know with his car. Can I come pick him up? But I was supposed to help my dad do something. And then my grandma's sick. And we never get enough period to relax and get things back to normal. And what's important is if you can find little places in your life to be at four, either with your toe, or maybe you've got just a knee park near your house and you want to take a walk in it, or maybe a cup of herb tea, anything that for you keeps you at four. Let me demonstrate why this is so important. We all swallow every day. We probably swallow 1,000 times a day. We don't think about it, right? It's a muscle reaction, just like in stress. So the stressor is you've got some saliva or food, you've got to swallow. Big deal. And you swallow, and then you go about your business, and the next time you have to swallow, you swallow. It's not a big deal. I would like you, I'm worried, to swallow 4 times in a row right now. Go ahead, swallow 4 times in a row. Come on, you all know how to swallow. What's the big deal? You know how to swallow. What's your problem? Okay, she's still stuck on three. Now, the reason you can't swallow 4 times in a row is because you couldn't give you weren't in four long enough to recover. You have to swallow and then recover. Swallow and then recover. So it's the same thing. You need to look at your life and say, when do I get a little bit of downtime? Maybe you put on your headphones and it's just 5 minutes. Maybe you go for a run. Maybe you take a hot shower. Whatever it is, when you feel stress building, bring it down, interrupt. Okay, so we all need stress in order to be productive. We're not trying to get rid of stress. We're trying to manage stress. And yet, if we have too much on our plate, then our productivity goes down. So what I'd like to ask you to do is to start looking for when you know, I need to be able to do these math problems. Not today, I can't do them at all. And pull yourself back up into high productivity. One way to do that is by deep breathing. And I'd like you to have an opportunity now to practice that. Because when you are under stress, you breathe very shallowly. And and so you can't think straight because you're not getting enough oxygen to your brain. So I'm going to ask you to close your eyes again, and I'm watching. Put your hand on your belly, and I want you to feel that first. Then, and you're going to take 8 short breaths in. We'll do it twice. Your stomach, your chest, and your shoulders. Just sort of visualize the air going in there, filling you up. Hold it, and then back out the same way. All right, so I'll count for you. So, 1, stomach, 2, 3, chest, 4, 5, 6, shoulders, 7, 8. And out, move this breast, 2, 3, chest, 4, 5, 6, stomach, 7, 8. And in, stomach, 2, 3, chest, 4, 5, 6, shoulders, 7, 8. And out, 2, 3, chest, 4, 5, 6, stomach, 7, 8. Now just with your eyes closed, regular breathing, visualize the air coming in, going out. In, did you check off? Tell me a number. Count it out. 2. All right, spending time close to nature. And the studies have shown that if you have a very quiet place, it's so gorgeous here, that big mountaintop. Even as between the sessions, I sat in my car and stared at that gorgeous snowy mountain. So anytime you can get close to nature, animals, planting, this will calm you down. So find a place that you like, it's nature, and go there. What's another number? 13. All right. Writing in a journal, and that was suggested by you this morning. Just getting your thoughts out. Nobody has to see it but you, and I'm going to have in my life where I just have a whole lot of writing, and it just empties that spot. I would write and write and write till I couldn't write anymore. Just on a, I don't have to have a fancy journal, just a pad. What else? What's another number? Excuse me. One. All right. Why is that important to you, to surround yourself with energizers instead of people who just suck all the goody out of you?
In a little
louder.
Yeah,
but why is it important for you to surround yourself with people who support you and energize you?
Because then I feel loved too.
Yeah, there are so many negative people in the world. And that's the way they think it is, that we should just do la la la. Because life has challenges. But we need to be around people who energize us, who support us. And so that's very important. Another number. I know we had numbers on this side. What number did you look at? Eight. Okay. Talk to someone who will listen. And we heard that this morning too. Who is that person? I'm really lucky, and I'm the youngest of four. I have a sister who's 18 years old, and she and I can get on the phone, and we can go on for an hour, and I know she'll just listen to me. Not necessarily tell me what to do, but just listen. And we need to have that person. Maybe they're in our family, maybe they're in our church, maybe they're in our school. But just listen. And you can do that for your friends too. All right, number 15. And you can write this in. Everything is important, but not very. Everything's important, but not very. And I know sometimes some of the things that I worry about, they don't happen. Right? And so everything is important, but not very. All right, now for the last few minutes, I want to look at resiliency.